Hey Internet, I'm Taylor and this is my vlog, and today I'm going to talk about a few new albums that I picked up. A lot of my friends have been asking me to recommend some of the new music that's been coming out and review a few of these really hyped up albums that are hitting this fall, so I figured why not just do a few videos where I do quick mini reviews of them, three at a time. So I'm going to do three albums today. I'm going to talk about The Killers' Battleborn, I'm going to talk about Amanda Palmer and the Grand Theft Orchestra's Theater's Evil, and I'm going to talk about Manana's Moms, and so we're just going to dive right in and talk about those and see how awesome they are. So the first album on the docket today is The Killers' Battleborn. This album just came out today, September 18th, and it's pretty awesome. It leaked a few weeks back, and The Killers did an official live stream of it on iTunes for a while, so chances are, if you're a Killers fan, you've already heard it, but if you haven't, you really need to find a stream of it. It's streaming all over the internet, legally, for free, or, you know, there's those not-so-legal options of acquiring it. But Battleborn is really cool. It's a really different direction from Day and Age, which was their previous record a few years ago before they went on hiatus. Day and Age was kind of loungy, it had a lot of saxophones and a lot of weird stuff going on, but Battleborn is really a return to old-school Killers. It feels like Sam's Town, it feels like Hot Fuzz, it feels like really big, guitar-heavy arena rock. There's a little bit of Springsteen to it that wasn't present on some of the other albums. There's a lot of, like, really vague songs about girls and, you know, those big crescendos that Springsteen writes. But that's not really a problem for me here. I mean, I don't like Springsteen, but I feel like The Killers put a big enough spin on it that it's worth your time. That being said, tonight, September 18th, The Killers are actually live streaming their record launch show through the American Express on Stage series on YouTube. So, it's free, it's a full concert stream. I strongly recommend you check it out, I know I'm going to. And if you haven't already, you should listen to Battleborn and probably pick it up, because it's worth your time. Someplace good, we can't wait till tomorrow. You gotta know that this is real, baby. Why you wanna fight it? It's the one thing you can't choose. Let's take a chance, baby. We can't lose. Hey, we all just run away. I knew it when I met you. I'm not gonna let you run. Next up, we've got Manana's Moms. If you're not familiar, Manana is a really interesting band. They're this group of guys who are basically computer geniuses. They wrote their own music authoring software and refuse to let anybody else use it. So everything they do is run through their own software, their own production techniques. And because of that, they get this really interestingly complex sound. It's kind of a math rocky, alt-pop type thing. And Moms is no exception. This is the band's third album, and by far their most aggressive. There's a lot of really awesome tracks on here with some really catchy hooks, and really in-your-face lyrics, which you don't catch on some of the other Manana records, particularly Mines, which is the album that came before this. Mine was a lot softer and smoother, and it felt like kind of fluid listening through it. Whereas Moms kind of punches you in the face a few times, and that's not at all a bad thing. It's pretty much everything I wanted out of this band. So, I would strongly suggest this if you're into kind of arty, mathy type alt-rock, and definitely if you're just into something that's really good for, like, studying or driving or any kind of, like, repetitive task. Manana's a great way to break that up. Save the best for last, Theater's Evil by Amanda Palmer and the Grand Theft Orchestra. If you're not familiar, Amanda Palmer is half of Dresden Dolls, who has gone on to a pretty impressive solo career. She's worked with a lot of really interesting artists and done a lot of interesting work. But recently she dropped her major label contract, like a lot of bands have, and chose to fund this album entirely through Kickstarter. So fans such as myself could pledge various amounts of money to get different versions of the album with more exclusive tracks, exclusive content. There was even a backer level where you could have Amanda Palmer come to your house and play a house party for you and your friends, which is pretty awesome. So I backed and I got the album a little bit early, but it did come out last week, so it's available in stores and online. And I think she's got a pay what you want option on her site as well if you're looking to get it for relatively cheap. But this album is worth your money. Theater is Evil is one of the strongest records I've heard all year. It's got great catchy piano pop, really dark, interesting ballads, great cabaret songs that we know Amanda and the Dresden Dolls for, and just generally awesome stuff. The deluxe edition that you get through Kickstarter also comes with some really cool B-sides and backup tracks, so things like Ukulele Anthem and a few covers, and just really cool things. If you're not familiar, Amanda Palmer is really into doing things that her fans are going to be proud of and aren't going to want to spend their money on, and she definitely shows that on this record. I would spend a ton of money on this record. That being said, I've already spent some to get a digital version, and I'm probably going to go out and buy a physical copy. So those are just a few of the new albums that I've been listening to. I'd strongly recommend that you all check them out. They're all available right now in physical stores, on iTunes, on Amazon MP3, and direct from the artist. So go ahead and check them out, purchase them, do what you do. If you like this video and you've got other albums that you want me to talk about, please let me know in comments down below. Otherwise, I'm just going to keep going through my recently added queue and talking about different albums each week until I run out of stuff to talk about. So, until next time.